Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 17.5 Beta 2. iOS 17.5 Beta 2 is out to developers and soon to public beta testers, usually by the time you're watching this video or the following day. Now this came in at 565.8 megabytes on my 15 Pro Max, and was about the same size on the iPad and other devices as well. Along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 17.5 Beta 2, WatchOS 10.5 Beta 2, along with tvOS and HomePodOS 17.5 Beta 2, macOS 14.5 Beta 2, and visionOS 1.2 Beta 2, along with older updates for Mac as well. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then we'll go to General, then About. And as you can see, the build number is 21F5058E, and this particular update does not have a modem update. So there is no change there as far as maybe modem connectivity or anything else, but it seemed to work pretty good in Beta 1. As far as new features, well, the big features actually come to the European Union, where we actually have a new option to allow for sideloading while you're using your app on the web instead of just through the App Store. So a third-party developer now has that choice, and Apple updated some documentation to provide information on that. So it says more options for apps distributed in the European Union. I've shown this before, but there's also a website update on their developer app showing how you can actually set up your app to distribute it through the website as well. So this is something that can be done and is now available in the European Union. And also if you're in the EU, there's some new options for this as well. So I have some screenshots sent in via viewer, and you'll see under content and privacy restrictions, under privacy, which is kind of an odd place to put this, and this is actually under screen time and then settings, you'll now have some new options for App Store and web to allow downloads and installations there. It doesn't seem to be throughout the OS yet. Maybe they'll update this a little bit later. So it's only found in this specific spot. Maybe it will be updated in the future to be located somewhere else. Also, there's one thing that was added recently in iOS for everyone, and that's the option to use an emulator in the App Store. Apple now allows developers to put emulators there, and today a new one was approved for NES. So this is called BIMI, and after they removed a previous one for Game Boy Advance, it looks like there's new Nintendo emulators and maybe some updates here as well. So this is brand new. I'll link it in the description if you want to check it out. Within our settings, if we go down to battery, under battery with iOS 17.5 Beta 1, some of the text options were a little odd. This has been updated and fixed in this update where it shows the correct things with optimized battery charging, 80% limit, and more. So that's been fixed in this update. Now, something else they've fixed is if we go into our messages or we're searching for an emoji, in previous updates, when you searched for the word Jerusalem, an emoji would appear. It no longer shows any emoji whatsoever. So that's been updated. It was only on specific keyboards throughout the world, but it doesn't show any longer. Also, something else they've updated has to do with notes. So if you go into notes and maybe you go into the tags folder, you'll get a new tip here that says automatically organize notes by tags, checklists, and more. So it looks like they're making some changes to notes throughout, and we may see more of these in future updates. Also, something else that's out to everyone right now is if you're in Ecuador, it now supports Apple Pay. So if you're using Apple Pay on your phone, you can now use that with select banks. So that's available there. Also in iOS 17.5 Beta 1, there was a feature that was found later on in Apple News. If you're an Apple News Plus subscriber, there's a new puzzle, and that I've mentioned before, and you'll see there's now leaderboards. And if we scroll down, you'll see that we have a new one for quartiles. That's new, but also something that goes along with this is there's leaderboards for Game Center. So if you've played this, you can see your leaderboards, and then of course share or just play this against someone else. So you now have that option if you want to use it. So if you're using Game Center, you'll see those leaderboards. Also, something that's been updated in Beta 1 that I wanted to mention since we haven't seen it in a couple weeks is under books. If we go to the top, we have a new option here at the top that shows us our status for reading. So if we tap on this here, you'll see our reading goals here. So if you have reading goals, you'll see it sort of fill in like you do with an activity on Apple Watch. Also, something they've kept, which is great. Hopefully they continue to keep this. If maybe we go into a podcast here and we'll go just go to a random one here. We'll turn this down. And if we resume and then we go home, you'll see that it actually changes the widget to match the actual podcast itself. So that's really nice. It's been updated and now looks a little different, and they've kept that. Also, something else they've haven't really changed back for some reason is the font size in the widget app. In iOS 17.4.1, it looks a little bit larger. I prefer the one in the previous update. Maybe they'll change it back. I thought maybe it was just a bug, though. Also, an app that's been updated that I wanted to let you know about is Apple Sports. It now includes NBA and NHL playoffs. So we have NHL, different games that are listed, as well as NBA also. If you go into that, anything today, and then there's things coming a little bit later, such as NFL, which is coming when the season returns, and I'm not sure if we're going to have Olympics, but maybe we'll have that here as well later on. Now, something that's not in this update still is a little bit odd to me, is if we go into the clock, go to stopwatch, hit start, they still haven't brought back that live activity that was there with iOS 17.4 betas for some reason. So if we stop this and we start a timer, it's there, but just not for the stopwatch. And there was a little bit of stutter there. I don't know if you saw that. Also, Apple has not brought back the feature where it would allow you to use Apple Music SharePlay with a HomePod or Apple TV. It doesn't appear to be there yet. It looks like maybe there could be something around that in the code, but we haven't really seen it pop up again. So maybe they'll bring that back with this update. Now, as far as bug fixes and release notes, well, they did fix a few things in the release notes. So if we go into the feedback app, this has been updated. So let's refresh here. It's also on the public facing website. But if we go into this, you can see the resolved issues with accessibility, mostly for programmers or developers. And then you'll see Core Motion. They have some new features for that for developers. And they've resolved some issues with StoreKit, where they fixed an issue where the Terms of Service button on the subscription store view could cause a crash when tapped. And there's still a known issue with wallpaper, where it says Add New Wallpaper Sheet does not load any content after restoring a device. So if you're having that issue with wallpaper, it's well known. But if you're having other issues, make sure you report them in the feedback app. As far as other bug fixes, well, I talked before with beta 1 with AirDrop, that seems to be nice and fast. So if I want to maybe AirDrop this to a different device here, so we'll AirDrop maybe over to the iPad. And let me show it on the 15 Pro Max here. It shows up immediately. Everything's working pretty quickly, and that seems to work well. Some other people have had issues with the camera. I haven't had an issue with it, but let me know if you're having an issue on the lock screen with the camera sort of showing up odd when you go into it. Sometimes you couldn't swipe out of it. So that's been an issue for some people. Also, AirPlay was disconnecting in beta 1 randomly for some people, whether that was wired or not, or even if your song was downloaded. I haven't been able to test this out, so it will take a few days to know that. The wallpaper dimming bug is still there, though. So if we swipe back home, let me close out this podcast here. The wallpaper dimming bug seems to still be there. So watch the bright area, and it just sort of desaturates after you swipe up. So no other bugs I've seen so far, but that's what we know about as far as this beta so far. Now, as far as performance, it seems to be very fast and smooth, and we'll take a look at Geekbench scores in a moment, but it seems to be nice and smooth. I did update the iPhone 11 with beta 2 as well, and this is the first time scrolling in it, so it's not 120 hertz, but it's nice and smooth. ProMotion on the 15 Pro Max is nice and smooth, and if we go into apps, maybe we'll go into music at the same time. We'll go home. You'll see it's nice and smooth in the 11, or maybe we'll go into, let's go to Safari quickly, and we'll go to Apple. Takes a moment to load. I'm not sure what website we're on. Let's go into Apple here on the iPhone 11, and there we go. Everything seems to load nice and quickly, so that's a great sign. As far as the overall heat, well, after installing the update on my 15 Pro Max, of course, it's going to be a little bit warm. We expect that. And it did seem to cool down very quickly in between actually running benchmark scores. So it seems like it's staying nice and cool. Of course, this will take a few days to measure along with battery. But as far as the battery goes, let's go ahead and take a look. So we'll go back in and you'll see my overall battery health is 99% with 159 cycles. I did use another phone the previous week for a few days, but now I'm back on this one. As far as battery life, well, I've run it the past few days. Yesterday, I only had 2 hours and 35 minutes of screen active time and used almost 75% of the battery. But depending on the day, it's actually been pretty good. Some days haven't. So far today, I've had 2 hours and 9 minutes of screen active time, 37 minutes of screen idle time, and we're down to 67%. So it's doing okay. Hopefully it improves in a few days. We'll have to check that after this has sort of been on here for a few days and see what it's like. As far as if you should install iOS 17.5 beta 2, well, if you're on beta 1, then absolutely I would install it. If you're on maybe iOS 17.4.1 and wanting to just try and solve something, I'd probably wait for the weekend follow-up to see how stable it is, especially since the public beta should be out by then. As far as the release date of iOS 17.5 beta 3, well, if we go into the calendar, typically we're at a 1 to 2 week schedule. We don't really know between beta 2 and beta 3, but next Tuesday or Wednesday we could see beta 3. If we don't see it then, it will be in May. But based on the release schedule of what we're expecting for new iPads, I would say probably next week, with maybe a release candidate after that, maybe after beta 3, and then a final release sometime in early May, maybe May 6th or sometime around then. We don't really know 100%, as Apple hasn't said, but we'll have to see what they do next week with beta 3. As far as a release in between, such as iOS 17.4.2, there could be something along those lines, but so far there's no sign of it in any website analytics that I've seen so far. So no one's reporting that as well. So maybe we won't have that at all. Of course, we don't really expect major changes until iOS 18 that Apple will show in June on June 10th. After WWDC, the keynote, usually around 3 or 4 p.m., we'll see iOS 18 beta 1, and that's where all of the new features will be, and then Apple will release that to the public, typically in September before the iPhone launch. So all of those things are expected, but most of the major features are really expected sometime around iOS 18. That's what Apple's saving all the features for. As far as benchmarks, let's go ahead and take a look at that. I ran it twice on this device and I have pretty good scores. 2,954 for single core, 7,268 for multi-core. Compared to previous versions, you'll see I ran it earlier today, but it's much higher than we've had for quite some time, going way back to different versions. So if we go back even into March, we're still not as good until, well, it's probably the best since maybe early March. So that's a good sign. It's working quite well. And again, like I said, it feels very smooth overall. So that's everything so far in iOS 17.5 beta 2. If I find anything else, of course, I'll share that in a later follow-up video on the weekend. And if you found anything else, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do, and if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe, and if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.